His Marxist ideology has impacted generations with books, plays, and even curriculum. But how much do you really know about Howard Zinn? That's next on One Nation. Hello, America. I'm Dr. Jake Jacobs. The English rock and roll band The Who, in their 1969 song Pinball Wizard, has this to say.
Ever since I was a young bird, I played the silver ball. From Soho down to Brighton, I must have played them all. But I ain't seen nothing like him in any amusement hall. That deaf, dumb, and blind kid sure plays a mean pinball.
Ever since I was a young boy, I played the silver ball. From Soho down to Brighton, I must have played them all. Well, I have actually been from Soho down to Brighton when I attended the University of Brighton in 1980 studying American and European history. I was introduced by a very left-wing professor to an American history textbook titled A People's History of the United States by Howard Zinn, a self-proclaimed Communist-Socialist professor at Boston University.
You want to read a real history book, read Howard Zinn's People's History of the United States. That book will knock you on your ass.
Ah, Goodwill Hunting. Zinn considered himself a social justice warrior who used his teaching platform, books, and plays as a tool to influence his students into transforming the United States of America into a socialistic state. A People's History has been assigned reading in many high schools and colleges across the United States and has sold over 2 million copies since 1980. Now, the problem with Zinn's very popular work, besides its failure to actually footnote his research, it is a twisted, perverted history that is anti-capitalistic, anti-Christian, anti-republic, and it's designed to fulfill his socialistic aims. Now, let's be honest. The United States, it's not a perfect nation. No nation in history has been. I have been teaching the good, the bad, and the ugly about American history for well over 30 years now. However, with that being said, the United States of America is still a wonderful and exceptional nation whose good has brought life, liberty, equality, and justice for millions and millions here and across the world. Now, sadly and unfortunately, Comrade Zinn only focuses in on the sin and the bad and the ugly in America as he attacks our founders as money-grubbing charlatans and traditional Christian values as bourgeois claptrap. Zinn is so in our culture and colleges that his friend, Hollywood actor Matt Damon, recommended that people should read Zinn's A People's History in the movie Goodwill Hunting. Do you remember that line from The Who, from Soho down to Brighton? Well, Soho is an area in the west end of London, England, and it's where, in a London pub called The Red Lion, Karl Marx wrote much of this notorious evil book he titled The Communist Manifesto. Well, Howard Zinn, a lover of the Communist Manifesto and its author, Karl Marx, actually wrote a play called Marx in Soho. Now, Zinn's Marxist play depicts a resurrected Marx who now lives in Soho, New York City, and he defends his communist ideas versus the 100 million plus people killed in his name. Marx in Soho amounts to a clarion defense of the principles of Marxism and the so-called wonderful ideas of Karl Marx's scientific socialism, where capitalism will be destroyed along with any nation that practices such free enterprise activities. Zinn's books and plays and teachings are primarily a diatribe against the United States of America and a defense of the evil ideas of Marxism. Zinn's works are so popular in high schools and colleges, they've actually created a Zinn education project that provides lesson plans, curriculums, conferences, and seminars where literally tens of thousands of teachers across this country are indoctrinated with Zinn's sins against our republic under God. That God Zinn hates passionately and taught against him all the time. Now, while Howard Zinn died in the year 2010 AD, he still lives on in his books, in his plays, and in his disciples, many of whom have become teachers in our high schools and our colleges today.
We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing ground. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. For without victory, there can be no survival.
Oh, I love Churchill. Every time I hear his speeches, I just get chills up my spine. You'd be do well to study Winston Churchill's speeches and his leadership. He's an amazing leader during World War II. Now, I just went to the movie Darkest Hour about Winston Churchill becoming the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom in the midst of National Socialism's dark and evil reign over Europe. Now, while I do have a problem with some of the historical inaccuracies, I would highly recommend seeing this film as you get a sense of the oratorical and leadership skills God so blessed Winston Churchill with. And like Churchill in his finest hour speech during Europe's darkest hour of Christ-hating socialism, we here in America see similar darkness as the lies of Marx and Dawkins and Darwin and Zinn continue to poison our children within. To paraphrase Winston Churchill, we Christians shall never surrender, and upon this battle depends the survival of Christian civilization. And I really, truly thank God that schools like Freedom Project Academy exist to counter the lies, the deception, and the twisted history by organizations like Zinn Education Project. This is Jake Jacobs. May the God of Israel bless you. And until next week, always remember, the truth will set you free. If you thought that was cool, check out more videos on freedomproject.com. You'll enjoy them.